Today, iOS 17 has been released and it includes a lot of new features. Some apps have been visually redesigned, like the phone app, other apps have received new features. I'm going to show you the 10 most useful new features and explain how they work, with the most useful features coming at the end. If you're not really convinced by any of these features, you might want to wait with the update for now. In 10th place for me is the new contact card or contact poster, a feature that is heavily advertised by Apple, but in my opinion is more of a gimmick. After installing iOS 17, you will be asked if you want to update your name and photo. You can of course do the update later. In the Contacts app, you select yourself, then Edit, and here, under your photo, Edit again. You can edit an existing poster or add a new one. You have four options to create a new poster: Camera, Photos, Memoji, or just a monogram without a picture. You can then customize your image, change the style or look, and change the color or font of your name. Of course, you can also create a contact poster for any other contact. If you do this, the posters created by your contacts will be deactivated. Your contact poster is a new way to present yourself, and it will be displayed when you call someone, for example. Using name drop, you can also share your contact poster via AirDrop by holding your iPhone very close to another iPhone. The contact information will then be shared automatically, so the fastest possible way to share your contact information. Name drop is also a new feature in iOS 17. 9th place for me is live voicemail. If someone calls you and you don't answer right away, but they leave you a voicemail, you see a transcript of that voicemail on your iPhone. Now you can still decide if the matter is urgent and you want to take the call after all. The catch, of course, is that it requires the caller to leave a voice message if you don't pick up the call. For me, the feature is only useful in theory, because it only works in the US and Canada for now. With Tap and Hold, the feature was introduced in iOS 16, with which with one tap you can lift objects or subjects in a picture, cut them out, and then paste them in another app. This feature has now been extended. You can now tap and hold an object in a photo or even a still image of a video, and then with Lookup, check, for example, what kind of plant or breed of dog it is. Basically, Tap and Hold has been combined with Visual Lookup, but Tap and Hold has gained another feature. You can now use your cutout image to create your own sticker. To do this, select Add Sticker, and your cutout object will be added to your own sticker collection. Here you can add effects or even create an animated sticker in the case of a live photo. By the way, in iOS 17 you can use stickers in a lot more ways than before, in more apps, or you can even add them to photos. If you want to prevent your eyes from getting tired quickly, you should not hold your iPhone too close while reading. Especially children should not do that for a long period of time to prevent nearsightedness. With screen distance, you can set your iPhone to check the distance to your screen, and if you hold your iPhone too close for a longer period of time, it will tell you and give you a warning. Quite a useful feature in my opinion. You activate it in the settings under screen time. iMessage has also received a number of new features. You can now reply directly to a specific message by swiping to the right on the respective message. This is especially interesting and useful in groups. iMessage has also received a new plus button. Here you can see all the things you frequently share more clearly and in one place. Stickers from different apps are now also clearly displayed in one place. In addition, a transcript of the spoken message is also displayed for audio messages. So no fundamental innovation, but many small improvements. And Siri has also been improved. You no longer need to say, "Hey Siri."
Siri.
Siri alone is enough. In addition, it is now possible to have a slightly more natural conversation with Siri. You can ask more questions or give commands without having to activate Siri again.
Set a timer of 10 minutes.
10 minutes, starting now.
A small but nice innovation. And finally, the autocorrect feature has been improved. Autocorrect was always one of the first features I disabled on a new iPhone. Constantly unwanted automatic corrections, some of which could be quickly overlooked. That has now changed. Autocorrect now dynamically adapts to the respective user and improves over time. Corrections are displayed by underlining the word in blue. With a tap on it, you can quickly select the word you typed again and also get other alternative suggestions. In any case, a good innovation. In addition, your iPhone tries to predict what you will write next, and you can confirm the suggestion via spacebar. Widgets are now finally interactive. Until now, widgets have mainly displayed information. This is still the case, but you can now not only tap on the widget to open the respective app, you can now perform certain actions within the widget. Like for example here in the podcast app, you can start and stop the playback of the podcast. Or you can check off a to-do list directly in the widget. Or from the home app widget, you can turn the lights on and off. That's another nice new feature. Actually, I would put the next feature in first place, but I don't do it predominantly because I couldn't test it extensively yet. Adaptive audio, a new feature for your AirPods. But unfortunately, it comes only for the AirPods Pro 2. Actually, it's several new features. Using adaptive noise control, transparency mode and noise cancellation dynamically adapt to the situation, depending on what ambient noise is detected. The transition is fluid and not abrupt. Personalized volume adjusts the volume to your personal listening habits and your environment. Conversation awareness, on the other hand, detects if you start a conversation with someone and reduces the volume of the media playback and amplifies the voice of the person you are talking to. There is also finally a mute feature that you can activate during a phone call, for example, by simply pressing your AirPods. Okay, certainly one of the most interesting and useful new features is the new standby mode. To activate it, place your iPhone horizontally and start charging it. Now the standby mode is activated automatically. Basically, the clock and other widgets are displayed in a clear and large size, so you can easily read the information even from a distance. So you can use your iPhone like a bedside clock or any interactive display that you place anywhere in the room. Of course, you can choose which widgets to display. This way, your iPhone also gets a use when you're at home and not actively using it. So did any of these new features convince you? If not, then there's no need to update right away. You can wait and see if the new operating system causes any problems in the coming weeks. So what are you going to do? Drop me a line in the comments. If you are interested in what well-hidden but really useful features your iPhone has, take a look at my according video about it. There will be a review of the new iPhone soon. So stay tuned and see you next time.